you're on the TUTOR Hotline with Melissa Maribel. How can I help you?
Hey, Melissa. I'm having a trouble with answering this question. It says, write the balance equation for each reaction below. Question C is stating that the reaction of sulfur dioxide with oxygen to form sulfur trioxide solid.
Okay, here it is. Let's go over that. So for questions like these, where they're pretty much word problems and we're trying to translate and see what they mean, the best thing is just to like identify keywords here. So first things first, of course, they're telling us the specific elements and, you know, compounds that are involved in this reaction. So the first thing that I want to identify right now is just what is sulfur dioxide, all right? So what is the chemical formula for it? So for sulfur dioxide, let's just start off with, is this an ionic compound, meaning is it a metal and a nonmetal, or is this a covalent compound, meaning it consists of two nonmetals? So how I instantly know it's covalent is just by the prefix. The fact that this has the word di there, that prefix, then I know that it has to be a covalent compound, meaning I don't have to balance any of the charges whatsoever. Okay, so in this case, it's really just sulfur, so S. Di refers to two. So for a covalent compound, that's always telling us, that prefix is always telling you how many of that specific element there are in this question. Okay, so in this case, it's dioxide, so there are two oxygen. So that's O2. And then remember, anything that ends in "-ide", just means that there's only one element there. There are some exceptions for some polyatomic ions, but for this type of question, that just means that it's just oxygen, okay? So this is SO2, that's what it's referred to as, sulfur dioxide. Continuing on, this now says with oxygen. Be aware of this. Sure, it says oxygen, and you would think, okay, it's singular, it's just one oxygen, it's not gonna be plural. That would be wrong. So oxygen doesn't exist on its own. Okay, this is a type of diatomic molecule. Diatomic molecules are really just molecules that exist in pairs. So instead of O, it's going to be O2. And then a lot of these are, like, let's say hydrogen is the typical type for it, any sort of halogen, and especially because this is a type of gas as well. So for oxygen, it's not just going to be O, it's going to be O2, and that's definitely something you need to know, okay? So they're trying to trick you there. And then next, it says to form sulfur trioxide. So I know, okay, well, this is sulfur trioxide. Once again, is this a ionic compound or is this covalent? The fact that there is a prefix here of tri tells me that, okay, it has to be covalent. I don't have to balance any charges whatsoever. So all I have to do is write this out where I know sulfur is S, tri is the prefix for three, so I know that there are three oxygens. So that's why it's SO3. Next part of this, now that we identified all of the different compounds that we're working with here in the types, then I wanna identify what are my reactants and what are my products. I need to identify major keywords here. So one of the major keywords here is the fact that it says with. So that with is telling me, okay, well, I know that that means plus. Okay, so whenever it says like, oh, sulfur trioxide and oxygen or with oxygen, that means we're adding those together. So the reaction of both of these, this says sulfur dioxide with oxygen, I know that both of these are going to be my reactants. Next, this states to form. If something is being formed, that means it's going to be your product. So I know that sulfur trioxide is now my product. All right, so that's the main thing here is that I'm just looking at, okay, what are the keywords and with, or sometimes it could even say sulfur dioxide reacts with oxygen. So that saying reacts also tells me it's a reactant. Now that I have identified those two, I can build this and put this together. So I know that these two are my reactants and it forms our sulfur trioxide. Next, we want to balance this out. What we're going to do is figure out how many of each elements there is on either side. So in this case, there's only one sulfur. We'll count how many oxygens there are. So here we have two plus this additional two because it is on the reactant side. So 2 + 2 would give us 4. I'll look at the other side here. So the product side, there's only one sulfur. And then due to the subscript of 3, there are 3 oxygens. What I will do now, because sulfur is balanced, it's fine, it's the oxygens that aren't. What I want to do let's say I'll put a 2 and I'm going to distribute this 2 and recount everything up, okay? So if I recount everything, this now is 2 sulfurs and this is 2 times 3, so 6. Now I'm trying to figure out what am I going to do, what am I going to place to make the amount of oxygens on the reactant side be 6. So instead of doing anything here with our oxygens, because the fact that sulfur has 2 now, that means we must place a 2 in front of SO2. So I have to have a 2 here. I'll distribute and recount everything on the reactant side. So I now have 2 sulfurs, and double checking here, this is 2 times 2, giving us 4. 4 plus this additional 2 would give us 6. So now everything is balanced so far. So now that we have this balanced, the next thing is just identifying all of our different states. So luckily, this question told you. So it told you that sulfur dioxide is a type of gas. So I know that that's how I'm going to label it. Next, it is known that diatomic molecules tend to be gases, so oxygen or hydrogen or some sort of halogen, those are types of gases. So this is going to be a gas. And then lastly, this tells you that sulfur trioxide is a type of solid. And this is how we get our final answer. This question is a common quiz and exam question, so make sure to lock that down and know how to do this. And if you feel like, you know what, I don't know what I'm doing in chemistry. Congratulations, you're human. And I didn't know what I was doing in chemistry either when I was taking it, okay? But all you have to do is show up, practice, keep going. Don't quit, all right? That's the key to success there. Now, if you want to get your question answered, then make sure to look at the description box. There you'll find the link to submit your question and so many other resources like notes, tutoring, homework help, and so much more. Just check it out. I'll see you next time, guys.